This one will never.
Upon felicitations, fellow Fanalos. Welcome to Manilow Monday. I hope that you had a good Super Bowl weekend. I didn't do anything. I'm not a big football fan. Somebody asked me who I was for. I said Taylor Swift. I don't know. Whoever makes the most home runs. But yeah, I hope you had a great day. I know as a manager for a large company, Super Bowl Monday, the day after the Super Bowl, was always the biggest day of the year for people to call in sick. So be responsible. I don't have any Manilow news this week. I was actually looking for some this week, and I really couldn't find anything. But I did, I live in Northern California, and I am in Napa Valley quite often, which is the wine capital of the United States. And I noticed that there is an official Barry Manilow wine. Now, I'm not sponsored by this at all. I have no sponsors. This is just me doing it for fun. But he has official Barry Manilow wines, and there's two levels of membership. You get two shipments per year, and I am looking at joining because there's a three-bottle membership and a six-bottle membership, and I might be doing that later today because, like I said, I'm in Napa Valley a couple times a year, at least, sometimes three or four, to do wine tasting and shop and do all that stuff. I love it over there. It's beautiful. So I don't know. We'll see. I'm very interested. It is a little bit pricey if you want to do the six bottle, but we'll see. We do have another song. We are still continuing our journey through Barry's studio album, his third studio album, trying to get the feeling again. We are on track two on side two, and it's a song. I always refer to Manilow Obscura, and this is one of those that not very many people know about. It was one of my favorites, and I almost put this on my solo project last year, my tribute to Barry, but I was getting really ballad heavy. I had a lot of ballads and not enough up-tempo, and I still think, I think I had three up-tempo and one moderate tempo. Everything else was ballads on that album, so I decided to cut this one. It was written by Barry Manilow and Adrian Anderson. It's called As Sure As I'm Standing Here, and it's a very sweet song. Lyrics are really, it's a typical Manilow ballad, quite frankly. And the intro is in the key of F. Sometimes I look at you, sad and so beautiful. It's just got really sweet lyrics. And yeah, it's got a very simple chord progression. There's a couple of strange key changes that you don't quite understand, like that move to D flat, major seventh, and then the F sharp major seventh, and then back down to the F chord in the intro. But the chorus has a really nice build to it. The lyrics are someone who has met a person that they care about and is trying to reassure them. Maybe this person's had a lot of trauma or drama in their life, and the person who is singing to the person who has had the trauma is telling them, hey, as sure as I'm standing here, you don't have to be afraid. You're not alone anymore. I am here for you. Basically, I got your back. And the message always rang with me. It's something, like I said, one of those Manilow Obscura pieces that every time I heard it, and when I was going back and doing all my, in 2020, when I was looking through all of my old Manilow albums, looking over the internet to see if there's something I missed, maybe something newer. I wanted to focus on the first 10 to 12 years of his career, but I wanted to see if there was anything else out. And I pulled this up on the album, and I was like, oh. And I actually put together a partial track for it. I started recording a track for this, and then I cut it. So nothing's stopping me from releasing it in the future. So there you go. It's a great little song. Let's listen to it. It's got a very sweet arrangement. I would play along with it a little bit because vinyl back in the day, speeds weren't always exact. It's in a quarter, a quarter key in between the key of E and F. So it's very off pitch with my keyboard. But I'm sorry, I have to be honest here. The lyrics in the second verse about watching her sleep and her hair comb with sunlight. Sometimes I think that's a little creepy. But the song itself is very sweet. I love it. I love the chord progression. I like the choice of instrumentation. It doesn't have traditional drums. It's congas, I guess, or bongos. I'm not sure I had that right, but I like that versus a regular rock and roll drum set. It just brings the energy down, keeps the song very intimate to me. I love the string, I love the piano, I love the rhythm guitar, the acoustic guitar in the very first verse that's playing the kind of finger picking during the underneath the piano. So, yeah, to me the whole thing just works. Again, I may end up doing this one myself because I just love the song. And speaking of doing songs myself, my new single is out. The Clock on the Wall was released on Wednesday the 7th. Please check it out. I'm very happy with it. It turned out very well. And kudos to those who helped me with it. And as far as helping me, I'm trying to learn to mix and master songs on my own. The mentor that I have was absolutely amazing. So I do want to thank everybody who's picked it up so far. But hey, it's out there on all the streaming platforms, so check it out. And we will see you next week. Thank you for watching today, and hopefully we'll be back next week. We are on track four, no, track three next week, which is another one of my favorite Manilow Obscura. Other people have done the song that we're going to do next week, but I love this song, and it's one of those, it's called A Nice Boy Like Me, and it's one of those anger kind of songs, breakup, love stinks kind of songs, and I love it. So we'll get into that one next week. But until then, take care, fellow Fanalos. Thanks for joining today.